agenda, and it's the same Aam Aadmi which is reeling under rising prices. Agriculture Minister Sharad Pawar has failed miserably to control the spiral, and to rub it in, he's making grossly irresponsible statements. No wonder then Pawar finds himself in the eye of a huge storm. The opposition is now baying for his blood. BJP says he's manipulating the futures market for personal gain. Santosh Tiwari with this special report.
Sharad Pawar might be no pundit, but even he knows that whenever he speaks, it creates panic. It was after this cheeky remark that sugar prices rose from rupees 36 per kg to a whopping rupees 50 per kilogram. The opposition is already gunning for the Food and Agriculture Minister, accusing him of manipulating the market for profit.
Kuch multinationals, kuch private corporates, कुछ मैनिपुलेटर्स कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज के द्वारा जो फॉरवर्ड ट्रेडिंग करते हैं, जिसके कारण ये दिक्कतें खड़ी हुई है, और इसके बारे में सरकार की नीति निर्धारण अगर ठीक होगा तो इसमें कुछ कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं.
नॉट मियरली द वीकर सेक्शंस एंड द बीपीएल बट ऑलमोस्ट द एंटायर मिडिल क्लास विच इज अफेक्टेड बाय inflation, particularly inflation of food articles.
It shows the callousness on the part of the government. It shows the mismanagement of the demand and supply of food items. It shows the government's failure to effectively intervene and control the prices.
But are the allegations true? Is Pawar manipulating the futures market for personal gain? Pawar says the country's milk supplies are severely scarce. This for a country that held the record of being the world's largest milk producer. India produced 104.8 million tons of milk in 2007 and 2008. The expectation for 2008 and 2009, an estimated 110 million tons.
If you look at food production, is not an issue. There's enough food in our inventories. It's much more an issue of can we get it out into the pockets of people that need it in time. Because the shame of it is that we could have food that's rotting in godowns but not reaching people that should.
Experts are deeply worried on whether the current inflation trend would lead to a hike in interest rates too.
In the country of Gandhi, the prices of food items are soaring. Not because there is scarcity of food, but because the government cannot manage food prices. And the worst part here is that if the prices move up like this, the interest rates will also go up, again affecting everybody. With Ashar Khan and Vishakha Talreja, Santosh Tiwari for Headlines Today in Delhi.
The Aam Aadmi, that's people like you and me, dal at 100 rupees a kilo, sugar from 17 to 50 and rising, onion from 8 rupees touching 30. What is Sharad Pawar doing about it? Nothing, absolutely nothing that will convince the Aam Aadmi that he's even trying. We're not the ones saying this. Let's hear it from the woman in the kitchen herself.
मिडिल क्या हाई क्लास फैमिली भी फील कर रही है बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम्स. और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि चीनी दूध ये जो है सारी सब्जियाँ दालें कहाँ रेट जा रहे हैं. एक आम आदमी तो इससे अच्छा मरना प्रेफर करेगा बजाय जीने के लिए.
The Aam Aadmi is angry, Mr. Pawar. The people are now pointing fingers at you.
तो वो तो पागल हुआ हुआ शरद पवार तो. उसको ये पता, वो कहता मेरे हाथ में कुछ नहीं है, मेरे बस में कुछ नहीं है, मैं कुछ भी नहीं कर सकता. तो वो तो कुछ भी बोल सकता है. और ये तो ट्रबल क्या, हर चीज़ महंगी हो रही है, अब दूध भी होगा.
नहीं लेंगे, आधा किलो ले लेंगे, यही है ना जी. किलो नहीं लेंगे, डेढ़ किलो नहीं लेंगे, आधा किलो में काम चलाएंगे. अपना तो बजट तो पूरा रखना, हमने कमाई है नहीं इतनी, तो करे कहाँ से बताओ आप.
गवर्नमेंट शुड वेक अप बट दे विल नॉट डू बिकॉज देयर इज करप्शन फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम.
India's benchmark food price inflation is touching an 11-year high. The year-on-year price rise is frightening, to put it mildly. The overall pulse prices have increased by more than 50%. Moong dal prices have jumped to 95 rupees. Urad and arhar are selling at 83 and 95 rupees respectively. The common man's staple, onion, has reached 40 rupees a kg. And even flour prices have leaped to 22 rupees a kg. And now there's more bad news for your household budget. You've already heard his prediction about milk prices. But Mr. Minister claims he has no control over rising vegetable prices either. And Pawar doesn't even want to talk of pulses. He remembers how international prices shot up after he spoke about sugar.
तो हम इंपोर्ट बढ़ाने के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं उनको क्लियर कट गाइडलाइंस दी है कि आपको और अवेलेबिलिटी बढ़ाने के लिए यू हैव टू डू सच एंड सच एंड थिंग आई डोंट वांट टू स्पीक मोर बिकॉज़ इट विल अगेन इंटरनेशनल प्राइसेस इस तरह ऊपर जाएगी
सिमी मेहता इज फाइंडिंग इट सो डिफिकल्ट टू रन अ किचन दैट शी इज नाउ इन अ मूड टू पिक अप हर रोलिंग पिन्स एंड शी इज नॉट अलोन
Government should do take some strong steps regarding it because we are getting affected, no doubt.
अपने पेट
Sharad Pawar says he's not an astrologer, but I think he's the best astrologer in the country because each time he opens his mouth, the prices of food commodities go just one way and that's up. So should Sharad Pawar be sacked for playing into the hands of hoarders? That's the demand that's being made by the opposition. That's really torn into the agriculture minister. Joining us on the center stage face-off this evening, Abhishek Manu Singh, the national spokesperson for the Congress Party. We've got Ajit Singh, former food and agriculture minister and also leader of the RLD. With me in the studio, one of the country's leading economic analysts, Sandeep Bamzai. Dr. Singhvi, I'll start with you. There are shortages all over the world. There are shortages in Australia, in America, in Brazil, in China. But nowhere in the world do we see the minister come out and internationally announce that we have a shortage. The moment he announces that rates go up, the opposition tonight is demanding that Sharad Pawar should be sacked. Is that a view you share? Because the Congress has been quite unhappy on record with the behavior of this minister.
You asked several questions in one. There's no question of the Congress agreeing with your notion or that of the opposition of sacking. But certainly, and I myself took the briefing today, conveying the Congress party's view that if there is a problem which the Honorable Minister articulates, that it is for the ministry and the Honorable Minister to find a solution as well. There's no doubt about that. Solutions have to come in the context of the problem, and it's not just a question of pointing out that something is broken. It has to be fixed, and the Congress party wants that. The Congress party has demanded it earlier, and pursuant to a very clear and categorical Congress party demand to that effect a few weeks ago, the minister had also made a statement, a very categorical statement, that within a reasonable time period, and he in fact specified the time period, prices would show a downward trend. So I believe that the Congress has made its very, very clear intention that we do not want to see price rise on essential commodities.
Ajit Singh, the Congress is washing its hands off this matter, saying it's the agriculture minister who has to deal with it. The Prime Minister is one of the country's best-known economists. Do you buy the theory being propounded by the Congress? This has got nothing to do with us. It's the NCP and Sharad Pawar who's to blame.
The agriculture minister is part of the cabinet, member of the cabinet. And the cabinet has to take the joint responsibility. Basically, it's a Congress government. There are some other parties' ministers, but Congress cannot wash its hands off. The recently, the bill that was brought before Parliament, where they were planning to pay the cane farmers only 129 rupees and 84 naya paisa, was cleared by the cabinet. There are 60 ministers there, and majority of them are congressmen. And if that bill would have been passed, sugar prices next year would have shot up to 150 rupees. So you cannot wash, Congress cannot wash its hands off. It's the cabinet which is jointly responsible, it's the government which is responsible. And it is because of the government's wrong policies that many of these commodities prices have gone up.
Sandeep Bamzai, there seems to be something dramatically amiss over here. It's happened way too often now. It almost seems, and the opposition is making very direct allegations now, that Sharad Pawar is hand in gloves with the hoarders because his statements have only been helping the hoarders and absolutely no one else.
Well, I'm no sympathizer of the opposition, but if it's broken, fix it. As a minister and handling such a sensitive portfolio at a time when there are clear supply imbalances, it is the minister's job not to behave, as he himself says, as a jyotishi, but he can't become a clairvoyant that every other day the man stands up and says, milk prices are going to rise, so brace yourselves. Rice prices are going to rise, so brace yourself. Sugar prices are going to rise, so brace yourselves. It is his job to give us a panacea, to give us the solution.
No, but does it make sense to come out and announce before the whole world that we have a shortage, rates are going to go up?
It's absolutely
because if you
bizarre.
Have a shortage, go internationally, procure the food grains to ensure that rates stay under control.
See, you know, Mr. Ajit Singh has made an extremely valid point. What happened with the FRP? The entire sugar crisis, the genesis of that is the ordinance which this government passed, which said that the FRP would be X and the mill owners will not be paying the differential, but the state government would, which brought complete anarchy on the streets of Delhi, and Mr. Ajit Singh himself was here agitating.
Abhishek Manu Singhvi, for a government that claims to be an Aam Aadmi government, the sense is that you can't wash your hands off this problem. You can't say Sharad Pawar is to blame. You are to blame as much because it's your party that leads this government, sir.
It's your phraseology. I never use the word wash our hands off. You've been going on and on about washing the hands off and nobody has said so. Nobody is denying that cabinet is a collective responsibility. Nobody is denying it's a UPA Congress-led government. Of course, we are deeply concerned.
So why don't you stop Sharad Pawar from making statements that help only hoarders and go against the Aam Aadmi you claim to stand for?
I want to... Let me complete. I would only like two things. One is that nobody can doubt our sincerity, our repeated, very, very categorical statements. Number two, I wish one of the people with you or elsewhere could give us that magical formula and I would press the button for you straight away to magically bring the prices down. If the government had that, we could do it. Now, okay. Certainly, the work of the government is divided amongst ministries. The primary ministry dealing with this is this. And therefore, we have said that the minister, the honorable minister, who does understand the subject very well with a vast experience, will also be able to find ways and means to control this problem. And okay. In fact, he has said so. And in fact, okay. He imposed a time limit himself.
I can see both Ajit Singh and Sandeep Bamzai want to respond to that. Mr. Singh, you've been a former food and agriculture minister yourself. Abhishek Manu Singh, we're saying tonight, where is this formula? Where is this magic wand that you'd like us to wave that will bring prices down? Because prices are going up because of international trends and domestic production. It's got nothing to do with just Sharad Pawar. It's unfair to blame him and target him.
First, I question whether the government has even now woken up to the problem. They are talking about calling chief ministers meeting now. They should have done it at least 4 or 5 months earlier. Even Congressman Abhishek Singhvi is giving statements in public that the minister should come out with solutions. It's the government's job to come out with solutions. Why don't they don't discuss it within themselves? As far as is the international situation and all that, there are few questions I like to ask. Farmers get paid 10 rupees kilo for wheat. Why the atta is selling for 22 rupees a kilo? Farmers getting 5 rupees kilo for on this thing, potatoes. Why is it selling for 25 rupees a kilo? What's wrong? What's wrong with the system? That's a government job to fix.
Dr. Singhvi, respond to that. There seem to be a lot of black marketeers, hoarders who are making all the money and you're allowing that to happen because you've not been able to stop Sharad Pawar from making these statements that are simply pushing up prices and doing nothing else and creating panic.
The first part of your comment just now is absolutely correct and the second two parts are completely mixed up and incorrect. Absolutely. Just look at our statements. We have been shouting from the rooftops that this differential that in the mandi in Delhi you get something in X and in the heart of Delhi you get it at 2X or 3X is just not possible.
But
it
Dr. Singhvi, shouting from the rooftops is okay if you're the opposition. You're not the opposition, you're the ruling party. You're speaking as if you're the opposition. So for you to shout through the rooftops is not enough. You've got to do something on the ground.
Can I request you that you've got two persons attacking the government and a third anchor doing the same. The least decency you can show is to give me enough time to reply. I haven't even done half of my answer and you interrupt me. That's not the way to do a debate. If you want to score a point, go ahead and score it.
Nobody is scoring a point. I'm just trying to ask you why are prices going up? You're saying you're shouting from the rooftops. We're saying that's not good enough. Please go on.
If you want to get some responses which are meaningful and not nitpick, you better hear me out. And I would request that if you are playing the role of an anchor, all the more, you should be a little more objective and hold your horses. I am saying that it is precisely, you started your statement by saying this is hoarding and black marketing. I am saying the government has been shouting from the rooftops that this is so. Now, who does this? Who has the primary responsibility to stop hoarding and black marketing? Does the central government have that power? Please understand our system. primarily, entirely, almost predominantly, that power is with the state governments. That's the meaning of shouting from the rooftops, because when we shout, we are shouting at the state governments, Congress or non-Congress. That's not the point. And tell me, what can the central government do directly to reduce this hoarding unless state governments take the most punitive and the strongest of actions? Now, I can understand you saying that some state governments have been better than others, and possibly some of the ones which have not been so good could be Congress governments. Well, in that case, I don't support it, in case there is any facts and figures. But don't make a generalized statement that the Congress government and the Minister of Agriculture at the center is encouraging hoarding. That's a perverse statement.
I'm not making it, the opposition said it, but Sandeep Bamzai wants to respond to you. Once again, it's the same argument being put forth by the center. They're saying it's the state that's to blame.
Let's not be subjective, let's be objective. The issue of sugar, the measures that were taken to as deterrents to the sugar spike were taken last week. Starting Ganesh Chaturthi, when the festive season kicked in, we've had sugar prices running away. For 6 months, from August onwards, there's been no action on sugar. So whether it is import of raw sugar, whether it is cutting duties, whether it is allowing 9 lakh tons of sugar lying in Kandla and Mundra to be sent to Uttar Pradesh or elsewhere in the country, it is the central government's custom and excise notification which did not allow the millers in Uttar Pradesh to source that sugar which was lying decaying, the raw sugar which was lying and decaying, which had been imported in Kandla and Mundra. So the point is, if one is to be objective, then there has to be coordinated action. Then there is the Essential Commodities Act. Why is that not being used? Whether it is the center, whether it is the states, that is immaterial. The problem is that everybody in the country is facing a problem, which is a spike in prices.
Abhishek Manu Singhvi, you're saying the state governments are to blame because they are not preventing hoarding from happening. My question is very simple. Why does Sharad Pawar, a minister in your government, have to come out and each time publicly announce that brace yourself because prices first of sugar, wheat, milk, rice are going to rise? Why does there need to be a public announcement? If there's a shortage, the government acts on it, imports these food grains from outside. You don't need to announce it. That's not what America does. That's not what China does. That's not what Brazil does.
Firstly, that's a question you have to ask him. Each person has his style. I certainly may do it differently. He's doing it differently. But let me tell you this. I don't quite think that he means it in the sense in which you have just made the comment. I don't think he means it in the sense of making an announcement. What he's trying to say is that he's received demands from milk producers saying this, that or the other, and he's worried about a rise in prices. It doesn't mean he's tacitly accepting it or encouraging it. I do agree with you that these things can be worded and handled differently, but I don't think the inference or the conclusion which you're drawing from it is justified.
Well, we also had a situation, Rahul, where the Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation, which is Amul as we know it, wrote to the same minister and other ministers in the government and told them that because of the drought, there is a problem with feed, with cattle, where milk production will be much lesser than what it was. So that again happened in August 2009. This is January. Instead of saying that milk prices are going to rise, brace yourselves, what has happened in the last 6 months? Has action been taken? It's very easy to, you know, stand at a pulpit and announce that prices are going to rise. What is this particular section of the government? Okay, let's keep the government out of it. This particular section of the vertical, this vertical of the government vector doing to control prices?
Okay, Ajit
Nothing
Singh,
is happening.
Abhishek Manu Singhvi says what Sharad Pawar is doing is coming out and warning people that they have a problem and prices will rise. You're saying that the opposition essentially is saying that he is standing to benefit and people close to him are benefiting from it. Do you agree that the minister needs to come out and say prices are going to rise because there is a shortfall? If he doesn't announce it, people will still be hurt by it. How do you respond to that?
First, let me come back to the earlier statement of Mr. Singhvi that hoarding is responsible. See, hoarding is a very small part which is responsible for the rise in prices. Mostly it's the policies of the central government and some policies of the state government which is responsible for the rising prices. If you go back to sugar, 2 years ago we had so much sugar we didn't have room to keep it. What the government did was ban the exports when the world prices were higher. Next year when world prices were low, government exported all the sugar by giving subsidies to the mill owners. And then they didn't announce the adequate prices for sugarcane, and 30% area was shown less for sugarcane this year than last year. That's the reason. Then what action did they take? Did they remove the excise duty? Did they remove the various, did they pressurize the state government to remove various taxes they levy? So basically, it's the government policies and the lack of action at the right time which is responsible for rising prices. As for hoarding and all that, what has Congress-led governments done in the state? Have they taken any action? The fact is, today the hoarder is not afraid of the government. Corruption down the line, he knows how to placate which officer, and therefore he's not worried about your Essential Commodities Act and the limits and everything.
Let me get one final word from Dr. Singhvi. That's a very important point that Ajit Singh is making. You're saying state governments are to blame. Okay, maybe they have a part of the blame, but tell him, what is it that the Congress governments have done in all the states where you rule to ensure that the situation in the Congress governments is better than the situation in other governments? Just respond to that.
As I said, every state government is obliged to do. I believe that there are many examples of good work being taken against hoarders. Rajasthan is a case in point, the state I come from. There is a genuine attempt to go after hoarders and prosecute them, and some of the stocks have certainly been in the market. And I was speaking only in the context of hoarding. I agree, hoarding is just one part of it. I'm not saying that's the only reason. But certainly, action has been taken in Rajasthan. Action has also been taken to an extent in other parts of India. I believe in Madhya Pradesh to an extent, although it's a non-Congress state. The point is that every state government is obliged. The central can exhort, can shout, can assist, can push. But beyond a point, it's the local level as far as hoarding alone is concerned. Now, as far as duties are concerned, let me tell you, in a lot of the essential items, duties are being reduced or abolished. You've had it recently, these policies. The problem is that these things sometimes take time to show results on the ground. And secondly, there is an international trend which we cannot escape and ignore of rising prices. Whether it is oil, whether it is food stocks. You see the trend, you see the figures. It's a double trebling within a year.
But it's also a well-known, established fact that Sharad Pawar and people close to him have significant interest in sugar, milk and agriculture. What's not okay is the public perception that these people are benefiting each time their minister comes out and says prices will go up. That is not okay. That is something Manmohan Singh, one of India's best-known economists and our current Prime Minister, needs to clamp down on and act upon. That's the point that's being made by the opposition, and that's the point that's being made by economic analysts like Sandeep Bamzai. For the moment, Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, Ajit Singh and Sandeep Bamzai, thank you very much for joining me on the Center Stage Face-Off for tonight. With that, it's a wrap of our show. Up next is Action Station, where Gautam Gambhir is now only one century away from equaling Don...